Hi everybody, I hope you're doing good. I'm Seb Jean. I'm here to show you how I made my track Lulu's Bazaar on my next EP Cliff, releasing on Quality Good Records. So I will show you like in depth how I created the track, created each part, intro, build up, drops, and also how I separated every elements to set up the vibe, build my drops and everything. So I will show you in details every single aspect of the tracks, like drums, the instruments that I use, synth, some effects also, and some tips that I can like give you because I'm generous today. Start with the introduction. I really wanted to create a dark vibe because Lulu's Bazaar is the track that's describing the frustration and the anger in the EP. So you got this dark atmosphere and also that Fearbringer vibe. There is this that kind of energy in this one. So I really wanted to set up the mood like with some sound design, some dark instruments and dark elements. So I will show you like directly how it looks like. Okay, so for the intro, I really wanted, as I said, to create that cinematic vibe and dark atmosphere. So I decided to put a simple piano at the beginning. So this one, so you can hear it in the beginning. It's a piano from a sample pack actually, but I really enjoyed the way that it sounded because it got this like tape effects, really interesting when you play it. Oh, that's not the good sound, sorry. That's my tag, but in slow-mo. So you got this piano right here. I really like the vibe and the way that it sounds because you got that tape effects on it, so it's really interesting. And when you play the layers, sorry, the chords, you got this layer of elements and it really gives a good texture to it. So I really enjoyed playing this piano and really find it interesting to put it in the beginning of the track. So as you can see, also in the beginning, you got some sound design and some textures in the beginning. So you got this texture from Kontakt actually. The sound bank is Gravity. It's really interesting when you're looking for some sounds, like some sound design effects, some impacts, some bass, and also some risers and swoosh. It's really interesting for this aspect. Let me show it to you. So you got this one. Yeah, this is Kontakt and this is Gravity. So actually you got a lot of you got several sound. Oh, this, and you can play with them. Like you got a lot of option, like to change the length, the power of the elements, also the twist, and you can like play with the FX and everything. So Gravity is really a go-to VST for me in term of sound designing to set the atmosphere. I really used it a lot to really build up that cinematic atmosphere that I wanted to give to the project. So I will show you also on this part. You got this piano. It is the theme piano of the EP Cliff. It is always playing in every tracks of the EP because I really wanted to create that theme piano for the EP. Like I found the idea like interesting to create a connection between each tracks with the storytelling. So for this track, I decided to add a little layer on it. So we got this reverb-y sounds behind it with this tiny texture. I really find it interesting to play it like that. Also, you got a lot of sound design that I played not on Kontakt for this one, but on Omnisphere. But I decided to consolidate them because it was like taking a lot of my CPU, and at the time I had some big problems with my computer, so it was like really complicated to work on it. So you got these elements right here. So again, dark texture. You got this also, like that glitchy vibe and glitchy elements that is playing during the intro. And this one is really special. It's because actually at the beginning it wasn't like sounding like that. It was more like some dishes or something like that, you know. But actually I really worked on it with Omnisphere and also some effects on FL Studio. Like also I use Portal a lot. I will show it to you for this part. So for this synth, I really use Portal to create that sound design effect. Like it sounds like a firework, like going everywhere. This is a synth that I use. It's from Omnisphere also. And this is this one, I guess. Yeah, this is this one. But I played a lot of effects on it, like some gates, some Portal effects that I had on it to create that sound, like really unique, sounding like a firework, but also with the dark vibe, with the bass that it's behind it, the impact also, to always have that cinematic vibe. It goes like this. As you can see, the sound is changing. So there is an automation right here, so you can see the automation changing it, so the sound progressively goes into the original one. Yeah, important to play with the automations and also always try to create some new sonorities when you, even if you like working with some presets, but you can like rework your presets to get something new. It's really important. Let's move to the build-up part. So for this build-up part, I really wanted to create something different from the drop, because actually the build-up, I create the build-up after the drops. So when I had the idea of the build-up, I was listening to Tame Impala and the album This Low Rush. So I was like really into that kind of vibe, but I really wanted to integrate that kind of vibe in this track. So that's why I played that kind of drums, like acoustic drums, but really with the deep impact. I really wanted to keep it like powerful. So you got this vibe, and it's right here with this button right here. So I will like isolate them so you can understand it a bit better. So you got this line is actually the main line of drums. I name it drum loop, because actually this is a drum loop that I made. And after that, you got that line. So I added a few elements to it. And you still have the atmosphere behind it. Still the dark vibe on it. So I really wanted to create that switch between the part, and when the drop come in, you really have a switch. So you really feel the difference between the build up, like that is not really chill, but kind of chill compared to the drop. So this is the build up, and after that you got the drop. So we will jump right into it right now. Oh. Okay, so for the drop, I really wanted to create a really aggressive lead melody for it. So it's coming from Omnisphere, actually. Let me find it. This is this one, I guess. Yeah, so this is this lead. It's really aggressive run. So I played it, added a lot of effects, portal, some gates. I reworked the EQ and I had to consolidate it so I can still work on the project. But actually it sounds like that alone. Play with the reverb, the stereo. So I really wanted to for it to be on mono and sometimes go really wide on the side. Most important part, I will show you how I made it. Let me isolate the drums so you can like listen to the drums of it. So actually you got a simple part and you got the kick, clap, shaker and some hats. Let me cut the hats for the moment. So you got the kick and the clap hitting like. Also the shaker to like give more power to the first kick of each buttons. And if you add the open hats and the hats, this is where the bounce is really getting to life. So I will show you a little tips that I use for the hats and open hats, but let me play it one by one. So you got the open hat. Then I will like play the first hat. And let me go back to. So this is something that I used to do. I always put them like at between 12 and 16 because I don't want it to hit directly on the clock. So I always put them a little bit on the right. It sounds more natural, more organic, and it really improves the groove, the swing, and the bounce of your track. So I always set my hats between 12 and 18. Same for my kick. My kick is not on zero, it's at 4, 0, 4. So when you see it, like 0, 4 also. So the bass, it really important. The bass on this track, I really love to play with several basses. So actually there is like 5 tracks of bass. There is this one that is the main bass of the track. Oh, that's a long note. You also got this one is shorter. So I really like to change the duration of the notes and also the sonority so you can have more variety variation on the low ends of the track. I'm not a big fan of glides, I used to, but that's why now I'm playing with several basses. So you always have some surprises effect on the low ends, and you can still get some space for the rest of the track. I love to play and to mix a lot of basses to create some combos. So I will show you how does it play. So you got some new rogue kind of bass, some growls like dubstep vibes, but also some like really trappy 808s mixed together to really create something different, like with the bounce, so it doesn't stay with the evolution of the pattern in the track. So I really find it interesting to play with a lot of bass, like play with some subs, with some 808 synth on Serum, or after that pitch down to create a kind of bass, and after that you can add some elements or some effects to it, so you really have a new sound. After that with the drums, it sounds just like that. Let me like just reopen them so you can catch the vibe. And I put the melody back. So when you mix everything together, you can have something like really unique like that, with a cool pattern of bass, like mixing a lot of basses, playing with your drums, like carefully trying to improve your groove by not setting them on zero, but always try to push them on the right to get that groove hitting way harder than you should. Also, I always try to create some variation on my patterns, like I'm not playing the same patterns of hat or the same patterns of kick. I always try to make a slight difference between each patterns, so it always create a new way to listen to the part. Actually, also between the behind the melody, you got the main lead, you also got this melodic shots, like you got a flute and also some chops. So I will show it to you by cutting the main lead. You see that flutes and also the melodic voice right here. The thing that I love to do with it is to play with the panning, like the left right, to always create some dynamic when you listen it with the headphones. So it's always changing positions, so it's really interesting. So yeah, it's a simple box actually, but I play with some left right effects to give more depth to the track. So yeah, this is most of it. You also got some perks. Oh yeah, you got some perks to it. Let me show you like the difference that the perks can add to the track. Like isolate the drums again and show you how those the perks affect the bounce of it. So actually you will focus on this pattern. Let me cut the other ones. I will like turn them on right after, but this pattern right here, this perk, you will listen to it like right now. So this one plays a big part of the bounce of the first drop. So listen carefully. It comes in like just to add a little detail between the hi-hats. I really find it interesting to add a few elements between the hi-hats just to give it more taste, add some spice to your food. It's the same for me. I love to play with perks. It is a synth. It's not even a perk, but I decided to play some really short notes, so it sounds like that. So I used it as a perk. I really find it interesting. And after that, you got a lot of perks. I really love to play with perks, slaps, and FX. So you got some little glitch, some texture, some foliage, everything. Always I try to add some variety to my sounds. So yeah, with every perks on and the drums, you got this. So yeah, really interesting and really important to add some perks and like really try to play with the drums also, like to create some variations. So yeah, let me jump right into the second drop. But before jumping into the second drop, there is a little surprise in the track. If you already listened to the track, you could have heard the voice of a kid at the end of the first drop, this voice. So for the record, this voice is the voice of my nephew. It was recorded like 2 years ago. He was in an aquarium. He was looking at some fish, and there were like a lot of fishes in the aquarium, and he was like, yo, this is a mess. So he just said it in French. So he said, il y a tout le bazar. So I decided to keep that sentence to put it in the track, because I find it really funny to add it. So it goes like this. So again, I decided to keep not exactly the same pattern of kick, because as you can see, this is not the same. There is a little bit more kicks on the second drop. Because there is a lot more space. The lead right here is not playing, so you got the pluck playing right here. Like, this is a pluck where I added some delay and some reverb on it, so it sounds like that. This is the pluck that I use, and I love to use plugs, so I really wanted to create a second drop like really different from the first one. So I decided to put a plug on it, because I always find it really efficient in a bounce. So yeah, I decided to add a plug to it. So I played this plug. Also, there is the flute shot behind it, and some other effects. This effect is also on the first part. Is playing also in the build-up, but I decided to change the notes of it in the second part. So yeah, as you can see, also for the melodies, I always try to push them on the right. So this one has 16, so the same rhythm that I use on the hi-hats. The hi-hats on this track, I think I put them on 12. 16, yeah, and also I think that the other pattern is on 12, yeah, 12. So I always played between 12 and 18, so that's why there is a few variations to it. But for the pluck, I always play them most of the time with the same rhythm that I play with the hi-hat. The pluck melody are really setting up the bounce and the groove of your drop. So the way you play the melody will set up the rhythm of the drop. It's really important to give some swing to the melody you play with the plug to always keep a good groove. So yeah, always push your elements to the right to create a good bounce. You still got the same DNA from the first drop, but I just decided to change the melody to create a new variation to it. There is also some vox and vocal shops on it, just right here. Oh, let me move it, because actually you can't hear anything this one. So you got some ad libs right here, and I always try to add some vocal shops, some ad libs, to really create that, you know, human aspect on the tracks. I really love it. I often add some vox, some ad libs to the tracks, even if it's only an instrumental. I really find it interesting to play with some vocals, so always add a few elements, some vox, some ads, and everything. During the second part of the second drop, you got the vox playing, so I will show it to you right now. And also I made a second call with the voice of my nephew, just to bring the second part of the drop, because there is a slight difference with the drums pattern. It's not the same pattern of hi-hat right here, so the rhythm is a bit different. So I really wanted to call that change with the voice of my nephew again, so I used it right here. It is not the same part, but it's saying the same thing. So decided to put it at the end of the first part of my second drop. So the next part is a bit different than the first one. So here we go. Sorry, the CPU is crying right now. Let me fix it. Okay, so as you can see, the second drop is a bit, second part of the second drop is a bit different than the first one. Also, there is a slight difference in the block, so it is not sounding the same. Like, you got a little chord playing. Like, I really wanted to add a layer to it to create the variation effect again. So you got this slight variation on it. Also, the melodic chop shot right here sounds a bit different too. And you got a little change with the add pattern right here. It's not really the same than this part. It's not the same add. So yeah, slight difference always, but you keep the same DNA and there's still a connection in the track. So always try to create some little differences to your track and to add some more elements to it. The second drop ends and I go back to the intro atmosphere, like the cinematic and dark atmosphere, but with a little touch of hope this time. I will show you why. So yeah, you go back with the main piano, but also the melody is slightly different. The chord progression is not like that dark actually. So it really changed the mood and really gives hope in the end of the track, because there is the voice of my nephew on it, like gives me hope also, because it reminds me like some good times. So that's why the mood of the track is changing in the end. But you still got the same vibe at the beginning, even if you got this little touch of hope in the end. I think I went into the biggest part of it. As you can see here, there is a lot of risers, some sweepers, always to give the connection between the parts. Like, you got some real connection right here, like reverse voices, or like swoosh, like everything. Try to always keep a connection in your tracks. If you don't, sometimes can be a bit like dry, a bit aggressive. You always have to, it can be interesting to play it that way, but it's better if you add some effects like risers, sweepers, just to call the end of the part and to bring the other part together. So also you got this noise, like this creaking, like always got to play with the sound design, some effects to create some connection to your tracks. That's it, I guess. I think that I went into every element of this track. So I hope that you enjoyed the breakdown of my track Ludus Bazaar. I had a lot of fun making it, and I hope that you enjoy it, and I hope that you will love the rest of the EP coming out at the end of the month. I hope you enjoyed the video and the breakdown. See you soon. Peace.